This collection is for the free spirit woman that really just want to be herself. My name is Emily and I am the designer for the woven team at Odd Molly.
My name is Anna and I'm a head of design for Odd Molly.
For this collection we collected inspiration from our lovely Swedish summer but also from other cultures.
There's a lot of embroidery, which I believe it's a statement for this collection. There's a lot of handmade details. We have also a lot of happy jacquards. It's a mix of the boho girl, the city girl, and the pretty girl.
We have some really bright and happy colors that are very vibrant. I don't know, you can feel the summer heat. And then we mix that with some more cold colors that feels like more a summer evening breeze. My main focus for this collection was to create this new interesting feeling, but still keep that very important Odd Molly DNA.
When it comes to sustainability, the team has worked a lot to improve the amount of sustainable material, both on cotton and on the viscose qualities. The woven part of the collection is mainly in sustainable material.
Some important trends for this season that you can find in our collection is the color green. And with that, I mean every different color of green. And then I really love our dresses, and that is also something important for the season, and our tunic dresses.
I have one favorite, that is the long crochet vest. The long vest you can wear on top of anything.
I'm longing to wear our dresses from this collection. We have some really beautiful pieces that are mixed fabrics with embroideries on. So I can just see myself wearing them at a garden party with my friends this summer.
I'm here with Kristin Roos, who is the head of production and sustainability at Odd Molly. Thank you for joining us in the studio, Kristin.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. So, the film that we've just watched is a really great insider's view of the design process and the company of Odd Molly. So could you tell me a bit more about the video that we've just seen?
Well, obviously the video is a presentation of the work behind this collection, Spring-Summer 21. I think also it gives a good impression of the whole concept of what Odd Molly is about, creating these beautiful, feminine and colorful garments that is made for a woman who really appreciates to have a wardrobe with garments that lasts more than just one season, both when it comes to style and quality. And as mentioned also in the movie, as you said, I'm working with sustainability and production. So I'm especially proud of this collection that we have really managed to take huge steps forward with our sustainable materials. This is a long-term goal we have had to increase the amount of sustainable materials in the collection. But there are challenges. It's not just to do sustainable materials. If it would be easy, then everybody would just do it. But now we have gone quite far. So as mentioned in the movie, all our viscose programs are now changed to more sustainable options like Tencel, Ecovero, and Lyocell. And the majority of the cotton is on its way to be organic. And all polyester is, of course, recycled. So I'm really happy about that.
So just before we move on, there are a few materials in there that people might not be particularly familiar with. So obviously cotton, people know what cotton
is.
But when we're talking about Tencel, can you talk me through those three materials you said and what they're made from and how those are sustainable?
Yeah, of course. I mean, now I just mentioned Ecovero, Tencel, and Lyocell. These are sort of viscose materials. The raw material you use is just like viscose, it's wood, wood pulp, but the process is made like in a closed loop system, so the environmental footprint is minimal compared to generic viscose, and it's made by a company called Lenzing, and this is the most sustainable option for viscose materials or cellulose materials we have right now.
So another thing that I probably should try and clarify for people watching is this idea of a closed loop. So this is a this is a phrase that we've heard quite a lot from brands throughout Fashion Week so far. So could you just explain a bit more what a closed loop kind of production system is?
Well, now I'm not really the expert of the production systems, obviously. But of course, there is a system that sort of takes care of what comes out. So the waste is minimal, and they take care of all the chemicals. And so it should be minimal environmental footprint.
Yeah, so so it's kind of helping the environment by making sure that nothing is kind of going back into the environment at the end. Like once something is made, it stays being used and reused.
Yeah, that's the idea about the closed loop, and also what we talk about when we talk about circularity and reuse, that
exactly,
everything goes back.
I think it's very clear looking at your website, and certainly from seeing the film just now, that Odd Molly is a brand that is very passionate about sustainability. And I think when you certainly visit the website, you can see that you have an incredibly detailed sustainability page, which is, which is great, because I think, you know, customers are getting a lot more interested and a lot more educated about where their clothes come from, how their clothes are made. And I think, you know, they're really demanding transparency from brands in what they're doing, and also in the systems that they can't change yet, but are working towards changing, because obviously the fashion industry is a huge global business that one brand, one person is not going to be able to change overnight.
No.
It needs to be worked towards. But why is sustainability so important to Odd Molly?
Well, first of all, as you also mentioned, I think sustainability is something that everybody talks about today for obvious reasons, because climate change is happening, and I think it's more or less common knowledge now that the fashion industry has an impact on the environment. So I think that it has been sort of mandatory for all fashion companies to work with sustainability. It's something that we all just should do. And for Odd Molly, why it's especially important for us, I would say that it has always been a very, very natural and central part of the DNA of the brand. The whole concept of Odd Molly is from the beginning built on the image of this imaginary person, Odd Molly, who is someone who is like a free spirit and someone who dares to go her own way, and values like love and caring for other people and making other people feel good are very important for her. So this has always been really a central part for us in the company. And we have had this saying in the company that Odd Molly is a brand with a mind, heart, and conscience. And this sentence we used already from the start of the brand, long before we actually had a sustainability strategy. But today, the whole work we do with sustainability is built around these three words. So this is something that has been with us forever. So it feels very natural for us to have sustainability high up on our agenda.
Yeah, I noticed on your sustainability page, I think people think sustainability is a lot about materials, which also we've talked about.
Yeah, that's
obviously
one part of it, yeah.
But the conversation is so much bigger than that.
Yeah, of course.
There's so many more parts to sustainability, from packaging to craftsmanship to supporting the right kind of working environments for people. And one of the things that I really liked about your sustainability page is you break down a lot of things that you're passionate about within the general umbrella term of sustainability. And one of the ones that I found really interesting was, apart from, you know, concentrating on sustainable business practices and concentrating on the longevity of garments, which are both important, you say, and I quote, Odd Molly wants to fight for the rights of women to decide how to live their lives and contribute to society. Which feels like a very big thing to be promising with clothes.
I know.
And some people might think, well, how does that really fit in with the idea of sustainability?
Of course.
So how do you put that into practice?
Yeah, first of all, of course, it reflects in our concept, because it's part of the concept that this Odmali person that I mentioned before, she is like someone who really dares to go her own way and be like a free spirit and break free from conventions. And our brand wants to inspire other people to do that as well. And our clothes are made for a woman who really just wants to dress up to be comfortable and beautiful, and not like she's slave under a specific trend. So, I mean, if you wake up in the morning and feel like you want to wear a colorful sweater because that makes you happy, then you should do that, even if all the other people in the office are wearing black, for example. But what we do also more specifically is that we are having collaborations with women that we think share the same values as us. And for example, in this collection, Spring Summer 21, we are collaborating with a really, really cool person called Karin Holmström. Her story is that she was having an ordinary full-time work, but she had another passion in life, and that was painting and being an artist. And it was her dream to work as an artist. And she dared to take this step and to quit her job and just go for her dream, and she managed. So today she's living on her art. And in this collection, we have based one of our print programs on a painting that she made. Actually, it is the dress I'm wearing.
Yeah, nice plug.
Yeah. So later on, when we are launching this collection, then we will also tell her story in our social media channels to lift her and help her, but also to let other people be inspired by her story, that she actually dared to take the chance and follow her dream and fulfill it.
Great. So when people want to see that's launching, what's your social media channel address that people should be following on Instagram?
Odmali.com or on Instagram, Odmali.
Just Odmali, at Odmali. Okay, great.
Or you have to ask the marketing department.
Sure, I'm sure you're right, it's fine. Cool, well, thank you so much for speaking to us, Kristen.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining us into the studio today and for bringing the video.
Yeah.
And we'll hope to see you at the next Stockholm Fashion Week in 6 months' time.
I'm sure you will. Thank you for having me.
Thank you.
Thank you.